नमस्कार फ्रेंड्स, सो हेयर वी आर अगेन टू डिस्कस लेक्चर नंबर 3 इन वीक 2 एंड टुडे आवर फोकस विल बी ऑन फंक्शनल एनालिसिस। एज ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेल अवेयर, वी हैव ऑलरेडी टेकन 2 लेक्चर्स ऑन वैल्यू इंजीनियरिंग। इन लेक्चर नंबर 1 वी डिस्कस द बेसिक एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ वैल्यू इंजीनियरिंग, इन विच वी हैव सीन दैट व्हाट इज वैल्यू इंजीनियरिंग, व्हाट आर द हिस्टोरिकल पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ वैल्यू इंजीनियरिंग and what are the application areas of value engineering, and we tried to see that what type of problems can be solved using value engineering. Then going to slightly on application side of value engineering, in the second lecture we discussed that what are the issues related to value engineering, why do we need to solve a problem using value engineering, and how we can identify a problem, that is problem identification for value engineering or for value analysis. Also we have seen a systematic method of solving the problems related to value engineering, that is value engineering job plan. In our first 2 lectures we have also discussed that why poor value enters into a product. If you remember, there were 5 or 6 points in which we have seen that why products have poor value. Moreover, we have also seen that why value engineering is helpful in solving the problems related to construction activities, related to service sector, relating to manufacturing of the different types of goods or products. So we have seen, by now we have basic understanding that value engineering is a helpful technique and it can be employed in various diverse fields of engineering and management, and this can help us to save lot of money for our organization. So functional analysis or functions are the backbone of any value engineering study. We have to understand that what is the function the product is delivering, or what is the function the service is delivering. If we take an example of a banking sector, initially in order to withdraw the money we have to go fill a form, deposit the form, we will get a token, and then we have to wait for some time. The token number will be called and then we will be called to the counter to collect our money. But over a period of time the procedures have changed. Now you have a single counter, you go to the counter, give your requisition and you get the money there itself. So what is that? That is saving money for the customer, and the time also is saved for the customer. Maybe the money is saved for the bank, because less number of people are now there in the bank. The activity of you can say serving the customers has been improved, and from the customer point of view he has to spend less time in the bank. So slight modification in the procedure has led to benefits not only for the banking system but also from the customer point of view. So these are simple examples where we can see the basic concept of value engineering can be easily applied. So we need to understand the function. Now in this particular example, what is the basic function? The function can be withdraw and money. So the basic function is withdraw money. Now we have to see how easily we can satisfy this function so that it is beneficial for the bank as well as it is beneficial for the customer. So with the change in the procedure, the basic function was satisfied. The customer is coming to the bank, he is withdrawing his money and he is going back. So the basic function is satisfied. Only change that has taken place is a change in the procedure, and because of the change the customer is also feeling happy and the banking system is also maybe more efficient and effective. So the summary overall is the overall value of this particular transaction has improved. Similarly, any product that you see around you will be having some value associated with it, which will be directly proportional to the function that product is delivering. So we need to first understand that what is the function that product is designed for and how that function can be achieved at the minimum possible cost. So our today's discussion will be to understand the different types of functions, that are there in the product, then we will see the functional cost analysis or functional cost mapping and try to understand that how that mapping will help us to identify the functions which can be eliminated or combined or maybe added. I am not saying that always we have to go for function deletion or function elimination. Many times in value engineering we will be adding some functions to the product in order to improve the overall value of the product. So let us now go through the presentation and try to understand the fundamental aspects related to the functions, and functions are the fundamental or backbone of the value engineering technique, and therefore we are emphasizing on functions because all other things in the approach are more or less systematic and is equivalent or can be analogous to any product design process. But the only difference that value engineering technique has is that it is a function based technique and our focus is always on the functions that the product are supposed to deliver or products are supposed to achieve. So let us now slowly try to understand the different types of functions that and then try to understand the function cost relationship with the help of an example. Now you can see on your screen, value engineering defines function as that which makes a product work or sell. So a product works or sell if it achieves the desired function reliably. Function is certainly the end result or action desired by the customer. Now in this pointer, what is the function? To point on the screen. So it is the end result of this product. So function is certainly the end result or action desired by the customer. Customer wants a function to be achieved reliably, efficiently and effectively by the product or service, or we can reframe the sentence as a product or service should achieve the desired function reliably, efficiently and effectively. Now from product designer point of view, if I am designing a product, I should ensure that I must ensure and I will ensure that the product delivers its intended function reliably, efficiently and effectively. Now questions that help us to achieve a function are, what is the purpose of the product? Now suppose we have to now identify, first thing is identifying the function of a product. Second stage can be analyzing the function. Third stage can be finalizing the function, that okay, how technically we will achieve that function. First thing is identify. Now to identify, if I say what is the function of the camera, very easily we can try to write it with the help of pen and a pencil, that what is the function of a camera. Somebody will write a sentence to record the audio as well as the video of something. So maybe it is a long sentence and it may clarify the scope of the camera or may not clarify. There may be other things also, like the camera is also storing the information. It may be converting the information from an audio file into some other format. So the overall functions are not clarified by a single sentence, that it is used to record the audio and the visual details of any object or any system. So the point is, we need to first identify that what are the functions. So for that, what we need to do, we need to break down, not physically breaking, but we need to divide the complete system into its individual components and then try to analyze that what is the function of individual component and how it is contributing to the overall system or the overall product, as in the case of the camera. So we have to first identify the function, and that we can do with simply asking a simple question, what is the purpose of the product? Second, what does it cost? Because we have to relate the two things, function and the cost. So what we have to see, what is the purpose, what is the cost, what is the worth. Now worth, you can say, can be the value of the product, that whether it is worth to spend that much money to acquire that product, that will add to the worth of the product, or that will be analogous to the worth of the product. What alternative would do the same job? Now, once we have identified the function, what has to be achieved, then comes the creativity phase, in which we have to see that what are the other alternatives available, what are the other methods of achieving the same function, but at a relatively lower cost. And is it exactly what it does for the customer? And that is the two points are summarized, can be summarized in a single sentence only, that we have to see that what are the other alternatives possible to achieve the desired function, but at a relatively lower cost. So that is our target of doing the functional analysis. Now let us see the word function. Usually there is a two-word definition, which is the apt and most crisp way of representing a function. Let us see. Project or a product is evaluated by identifying the function in two words. So two words is the catchword here, and many times in from examination point of view also, sometimes you may be required to write the two-word functional definition of maybe some common products. For example, my watch. What can be the two-word functional definition for this watch? It can be show time. So it is a verb and a noun. So here you can see it is highlighted a verb and a noun. So the first word will represent a verb, and the second word will represent a noun. So it will be a two-word combination which will help you to identify the function of a particular product. Now even as an exercise in your surrounding, you can see maybe 4 or 5 different products and try to identify their function with the help of verb and a noun. One simple example I can give you is a chair. All of you may be having chair around you, or some of you may even be sitting on the chair. So chair, if you see the verb and the noun definition, you can say provide seat, provide S-E-A-T, seat. So it is a verb and a noun definition of a chair, and it is a functional definition of chair. Now once you do the further analysis, you need to see that how this product can be redesigned, how this product can, or how this function can be achieved by without using this chair. So now your focus is your solution you are removing. Solution is chair, so you are removing the solution, but you have a function in your mind that I am standing and I need a seat. So you will look at the various alternatives which can help you to solve the problem of providing a seat to any customer. So that is a verb and a noun definition. One example I have already given you. You can do exercise, you can identify 10 products around you and write their verb and noun definition. So verb describes the specific action to achieve the intended purpose. So again I am reading, it describes the specific action to achieve the intended purpose. So noun defines the object onto which the action operates. Defines the object onto which the action operates. For example, transmit torque. So you can say, what is the basic function of a shaft? Transmit torque. So transmit describes the specific action to achieve the intended function. What is the intended function? To transmit the torque. And then defines the object onto which the action operates. So this is the second word, that is noun, that is torque. So you have verb and a noun definition. For example, you can take watch, show and time. Example can be an electrical cable has a function of conducting current. So conduct is verb and current is noun. So you have a verb and a noun definition of an electrical cable, that is conduct the current. So that is basically, you can see, a very simple way to identify the functions of the product. Now there are different types of functions and different types of values for the product. If you see around you the different products, for example, I am wearing a necktie, and in necktie what can be the two purposes for wearing the tie? One can be that it looks good on me, so I am wearing a necktie. Another thing can be that it saves me from my chest from cold, so it has got maybe some other function also, or maybe that function we can call as a use function. So different products that you see around you will have different types of functions. So similarly, the products will have different types of value. So you can have a use value, esteem value, exchange value, cost value. Let us see one by one. What is the use value? Value received from the performance of the product. So if you are having a car and you are driving from Roorkee to Delhi, 4 passengers traveling in that car, so the basic function of the car can be transfer passengers, so, or transfer people. So if 4 people are getting transported, or maybe they are moving or they are traveling from city A to city B by a particular car, so car is delivering its use value. Esteem value, aesthetics and appeal of the product. Now suppose that car has a tag of a well known multinational company and it is a very costly car, it may have esteem value, then it has esteem value also. Maybe it is having both the use value, because it is the passengers are traveling in that car. It has got esteem value also, because it is a branded car of a very well known company. Then the exchange value, amount accepted in trade for an item. Now suppose you want to sell that car, so that then it will certainly have some exchange value. And finally the cost value, the money incurred to produce an item. So you, when somebody has bought it for a particular price, or a company which has manufactured it by spending the resources, will have, therefore the car will have some cost value also. So if you see, all these 4 values will be different. I have given the example of a car. So for car, use value, esteem value, exchange value and cost value, all these values will be different. But from a product designer point of view, you have to take into account almost all the values. But from a value engineer point of view, our major focus will be on the use and the esteem value. We may not be that much bothered about the exchange, although we have to take into account these values also, but use value and esteem value are the most important value functions that we have to take into account. We have to see that if a customer is going to buy this product, first thing will be the use value for which the product is useful for the customer. Now let us see, these values can be related directly to the functions. If you see in our first presentation, if you remember, we have seen value is equal to performance by cost, or performance can be performance of what? Performance of the functions for which the product has been designed. So if you see, functions can be of two types, primary functions and the secondary functions. Now primary functions can be, maybe for any, if you see a pencil, the primary function can be that you are able to make marks on a piece of paper, so that is the primary function of the product. But suppose the pencil, it is also printed that save trees. So save trees become, or that message becomes, the secondary function for that particular product. Primary function is to make marks, secondary function is the message that the pencil is spreading to whosoever is reading or using that saves trees, that you have to save the trees for the betterment of the environment. So every product will have primary functions and secondary functions. Let us take another example. Suppose you are using a nail cutter. So the primary function will be cut nails. Anybody is buying a nail cutter for simple purpose, basic function, that is cut nails. But it may be having a filer also, so filer may be the secondary function. So secondary functions help the product to achieve, sometimes the secondary function will help the product to achieve the primary function also. So that is a combination of the functions will always exist for every product. Now you can see around you 4 or 5 or 6 different products and try to see that what is the primary function of that product and what are the additional secondary functions for that product. Now same thing we will try to understand with the help of 2 examples. I have already taken 2 examples of pencil and a nail cutter. Now let us see the example of this electric kettle. Primary functions are the basic functions, cannot be changed. For any product, your primary function or the basic function has to be achieved, it cannot be changed. But secondary functions are the supporting functions, can be modified or eliminated during the value engineering study or the value analysis procedure. So we can work on these secondary functions and try to optimize the cost of the product, but we cannot compromise with the basic functions, though those functions definitely will have to be achieved in order to make a product successful. Now for electric kettle, let us see base primary functions. It is written in green color only. The primary function for electric kettle is boil water, pour water safely. secondary functions are indicate level of water, it should be cordless, water filtration process or this thing facility should be there, and power indication should be there, this red color, whether it is on or off. So from basic function is boil water, but secondary functions are it can be cordless and water filtration facilities and all. So you can see, if you are buying a electric kettle, these things have to be ensured. These things may be there. If they are there, maybe they are adding some value to the product. Even if they are not there, very basic model of this thing should have these two facilities of boiling the water and pouring the water safely. So we have a combination of primary functions and the secondary functions here. Similarly, let us take an example of a mobile phone. What are the primary functions? Make phone calls, send text message, or portability. Secondary functions can be, it may have a camera, it should be able to record a video or a play video, social networking may be there on the side, maybe data and other internet connectivity should be there, games, internet, apps, various apps it should support. So these are the secondary functions. So for a very basic model of mobile phone, these three things should be satisfied. But for advanced, highly functional mobile phone, all other things should also be there. So when you are designing a product, you have to see that what is the basic function that the product has to achieve, and then you have to see what additional secondary functions can be added on top of the basic functions so that the product becomes saleable or it becomes a success in the market. So these are two examples we have tried to explain. Similarly, we can also say that there are use functions and there are esteem functions. So we have seen the four types of value. It was use value for the customer, it was esteem value, it was cost value, and it was exchange value. So different types of value, similarly different types of functions are also there. You can have use functions, you can have esteem functions. For example, sometimes there will be products which only have use function and have no esteem functions. For example, the petrol or the diesel or the gasoline that goes in to your vehicle may not be having any esteem function, but it has definitely got a very important use function. Whereas the jewelry items that we wear, or maybe the nail that goes into the wall, or the winding that is done over the motor has got use value, but has not got any esteem value. But the jewelry items definitely has got the esteem value. So we need to identify the products, that which products have got use value and which products have got esteem value, as well as we have to make a compromise that how much of use value should be added into the product and how much of esteem value should be added into the product. There was slight confusion, so let me again clarify a difference between the two. Use value, let us take at least two products. Use value, first product can be the petrol or the diesel or the gasoline. It has got use value, but it has no esteem value. Similarly, the nail that goes into the wall, it has got use value, but has got no esteem value. Alright, but now let us see the esteem value. The scenery that you decorate in your drawing room or in your sitting room has got the esteem value, but may not have got any use value. Similarly, a flower vase in which you put the flower petals, that will also have esteem value, but may not be having much of use value. Third example can be the jewelry items that we like. I am wearing a ring, may have got esteem value, but has got no use value. So we can see that there are products which have got use functions only, there are products which have got esteem functions only, and there will be products which will have both the functions. Now let us take an example. Suppose I am wearing a necktie and I use a tie pin to support the tie. Now tie pin is holding my tie at its place, so the tie pin has got a use value. Definitely it has got a use value because it is supporting my tie, fixing my tie at its place. But it has got a esteem value also if I use a diamond studded tie pin. So if it is a diamond studded tie pin, it will be very costly. It may be of a very high end multinational branded company. So there will be a logo of that company on the tie pin. So it is a costly tie pin. Therefore, we can say it has got a steam value as well as the use value. So there will be products which will have both use value and steam value, or the use function as well as the steam function. And as a product designer, I have to take a call that how much should be the use function and how much should be the steam function, so that the product is cost competitive in the market. Now let us see the functional analysis. How do we do the functional analysis? If you have understood the basic and the secondary functions, very easily you can take a call on this functional analysis. Now we have taken this maybe lamp post. You can see what are the various parts here. Foundation is there somewhere here. Foundation definitely will be there. There will be anchor bolts, there will be base, there will be extension arm for holding the lamp, there will be a housing, there will be a light bulb. So what we have done, we have taken a assembled product, and in that assembled product, there we have divided it into its individual components. So here you can see what are the individual components: foundation, anchor bolts, base, extension arm, housing and light bulb. Then we have tried to see what is the function, and if you see the function, we have already seen verb and a noun. So it will be a two word functional definition. So function we are representing by two words only. So foundation, what is the function? Support load, resist load, transfer load. So verb and a noun definition. So out of this, the red color is only the basic function for the foundation. The other two are secondary functions. Similarly, for anchor bolts, transfer load is the only basic function. The hold the pole is a secondary function for the anchor bolts. So for each and every part or component of the you can say this pole or this lamp post, we have divided it into the functions. Which are the basic functions, what are the secondary functions. Now when we redesign this pole or we want to achieve this function, what can be the overall basic function of lamp post? It is to provide light or to provide illumination. So then we will see whether all these parts are required, what are the basic functions that are required, or whether this is the only design that is possible to satisfy the function of providing illumination, or there can be some other functions in which some of these parts can be eliminated and cost can be saved. But the target will be that we need not compromise on the level of illumination, the area the lamp post is covering, the safety aspects also, the reliability aspects also, the durability aspects also. So there will be no compromise whatsoever on any aspects related to the product design or the product quality. But we will see that how this basic function can be achieved by minimum number of components and without compromising the quality. So we will not go into the detail of each and every part, but the overall summary is that any product which is assembled product, we can divide it into its individual components and then see for each component what are the basic functions, what are the secondary functions, and finally try to find out and work on the secondary functions only in order to redesign the product, or you can say come up with a alternative product which can achieve the desired function at a relatively lower cost. Now let us take another example. Let us see the steps to perform the functional analysis. Very quickly I will go through these four steps. First is random function identification, that is identification of the function we have already seen, random function identification. Then fast diagramming technique, this we will cover in the next discussion. Cost to function relationships, this we will cover in today's lecture. Identify the functions that have the best opportunity to improve the value. So to summarize this slide, we have to first identify the function and then establish a functional cost matrix or a functional cost relationship, and then see what are the secondary functions or tertiary functions contributing to the cost, and try to eliminate or combine those functions in order to improve the overall value of the product. Now let us take one example. In random function identification, it is beginning of the function analysis phase. Okay, we have to identify a two word functional definition. Randomly determining verb noun combinations that describe the functions of the project or the product under study. verb noun definition already explained to you. Listing the functions of the entire product and identifying the basic functions, we will try to understand it with the help of an example. And the then bill of material of each component is prepared, and identify the function or functions of each and every part in the bill of material. So same thing we have done for the lamp post, same thing we can do, but cost we have not considered there. Let us consider the cost also here. Now this is the last, you can say, part of our discussion today, that is a functional cost relationship. If you have understood the function, the basic function, the secondary function, the use function, the esteem function, it will be easy for you to appreciate this slide. This is for the wooden pencil. And in wooden pencil, you can see what are the various components. This pencil has got an eraser at its end, and a metal cap is used to fix this eraser on the wooden structure or the wooden part. Let us try to see now. The component is lead, wood, metal cap, eraser, shaping of wood, printing. So all these are going into the manufacturing of the pencil. Now lead will make mark. Again the functional definition, two word functional definition, verb and a noun functional definition. Lead used to make marks, wood protect the lead, metal cap hold the eraser, eraser remove marks, shaping of wood provide grip, printing display information. So for each and every component that goes into this, which adds to the total cost, we have identified the function. And what is the basic function of a pencil? To make marks, and that is achieved only by one component. Other are all adding to the overall cost and are secondary functions, and secondary functions are also important in order to ensure that the basic function of making the marks is achieved successfully. Now from the analysis point of view, we can see only 50 paisa or 10% of the total cost is being spent on achieving the basic function of the product. The 90% of the cost is, or maybe the overall cost is going into making or into ensuring that the basic function is achieved successfully. So our focus area as a product designer or a value engineer has to be this additional cost on secondary functions. And we can see what all are the secondary functions that we can eliminate in order to, or we can combine in order to make it a valuable product for the customer. So in this way we will do the functional analysis, and we will be able to redesign or reinvent the product in order to improve its value. So we will start our discussion in the next lecture from this slide only, and we will cover the fast diagramming approach in our next lecture. I need to explain slightly more detailed analysis of this particular slide, since for this lecture our schedule is over. So we will start our discussion from this slide again in our next lecture. Thank you very much.